The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Welcome back to my channel. Friends, today we are going to talk about an athlete's foot. Yes. Athlete's foot is a disease, it's an infection which is because of a fungal infection in the feet, and its medical term is Tinea pedis. It is also called ringworm of the foot. Ringworm is not a worm, it's a fungus, yes. And it is very common in athletes, that's why it's called athlete's foot. So today we are going to talk about what causes athlete's foot, what are the tests, what are the symptoms, what are the treatment, everything. Stay tuned. So, what causes such a fungal infection in the foot of an athlete? See, in this case, fungus actually grows on the skin of the feet, and the same fungus can actually grow on other parts of the body as well. However, the feet is the most commonly affected, especially between the toes. An athlete's foot is most commonly because of a type of a fungus called Tinea, right? And this fungus basically thrives on warm and moist areas, and you will have a higher risk of having this problem if you are wearing a very closed shoes, especially which are lined by plastics, because plastic won't allow airs to go inside, and that's why your foot will be wet and moist. And if you actually keep your foot wet for a long time, if you sweat a lot, or if you actually develop a minor scratch or minor skin or nail injury, then also you have a higher chances of having this fungal infection. See, athlete's foot can easily spread. It can spread through direct contact with the items such as shoes, stockings, right, your shower and pool surfaces, because the foot actually spreads the fungus very easily. So if you are coming in contact with somebody who has the infection, you can have the infection. If you have the infection, what are the symptoms? The most common symptom is cracked, flaking, peeling skin between the toes. That's the most common. See, if you find cracked, peeling, flaking skin between the toes, you might have this infection. Now, this can have on one side or on both the sides of the foot as well. See, the other symptoms which can have is red, itchy skin, right? You might have burning or stinging pain. You can even have blisters that ooze or get crusty in between the foot, right, in between the toes. If the fungal infection can spread, if the fungal infection spreads to the nails, then the nails can become discolored, they can thicken or even get crumbled. See, athlete's foot may occur at the same time as other fungal or yeast infections, such as jock itch, which is the itching which happens under your pants, right? So what are the tests? How you can diagnose? See, a doctor can actually diagnose an athlete's foot by simply looking at your skin. And if sometimes tests are needed, the tests can be done in the simple office test of a KH exam of a fungus can be done by taking out skin scraping. Skin culture can be done. Skin biopsy may also be performed with a specialist, which is called a pass stain, to identify the fungus, but it's not necessary all the time. Treatment. See, over-the-counter antifungal powders or creams can help control the infection. What do they contain? See, they contain antifungal medicines like miconazole, clotrimazole, terbinafine, and tolnaflate. All these things, or one of these medicines, can be there in those over-the-counter antifungal powders, antifungal creams. You can use these. You can use them without a prescription, and you need to keep using these medicines 1 to 2 weeks after the infection has already all have cleared, to prevent it from returning again and again. It's very important to keep using them. In addition, you need to keep your feet clean and dry. especially between your toes. You need to wash your feet thoroughly with soap and water and dry the area carefully and completely. Try to do this at least twice a day, and then to widen and keep the web spaces, that is the area between the toes, dry, you can use lamb's wool. Basically, you can use wool between. This can be very easily available. Sometimes you have this available in your house. You can wear clean cotton socks and change your socks and shoes as often as needed to keep your feet dry. See, your shoes is shoes. You need to clean your shoes also. Wear your sandals or flip flops. If you actually are going to public places, public shower, public food, then wear sandals or flip-flops, right? Don't wear shoes, and use antifungal or drying powders to prevent athlete fruits if you tend to get it very often, or if you frequently go to such places where athlete's foot fungus can be very common, like public showers. If you go there, then you should prevent by using dusting, antifungal dusting powders. See, wear shoes that are well ventilated and made up of natural materials such as leather, right? Leather, and it may help to actually alternate. It may also help to alternate shoes each day so that they can actually become completely dry. Don't wear the same shoe again and again, and do not wear plastic lined shoes, right? Other canvas shoes are also very much better than leather also, right? If athlete's foot does not get better in 2 to 4 weeks of self-care and frequently returns, then you need to see a doctor. Doctor will provide you with antifungal medication to be taken from the mouth, by the mouth, and antibiotics may also be given to treat any bacterial additional infection which might happen because of scratching. Prescription creams can also be given which can kill the fungus. Again, remember, these kind of athlete foods almost always responds well to self-care, although it may come back again and again, but long-term medicine and preventive measures might be needed, and the infection can spread to the toenail. So don't worry, self-care needs to be done, and sometimes you can go to the doctor. When should you go? If your foot is swollen and it's warm to touch, especially if there is a red streak or pain, if there is pain or bleeding, then possibly there is a bacterial infection in addition to other things, and other signs like pus or fever can also be there. And sometimes athlete's foot will not go away after 2 to 4 weeks of self-care, then you should go to a doctor. Remember, athlete's foot is the same thing as fungal infection, tiniasis, or ringworm of the foot. Tinea pedis, it is very common. You can prevent it, you can easily treat it, but you need to know about it. So that's why I share this video with your friends, and especially if you know any athlete, this is really important for them. So stay connected, stay healthy.